Hey folks, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a review of a fairly large LEGO Star Wars set. This is set number 75021, a Republic gunship, the summer 2013 version of a Republic gunship. And it has 1,175 pieces, 1,175 pieces, and costs $120 in the United States. Now, I know me, I know that I get really wordy with reviews, especially with big stuff. So I'm gonna first take you right into the minifigures and try to get through them quickly so I can focus for a long time on the ship itself. Here we go. These are from the movie franchise, so not Clone Wars, so they have the slightly more realistic look to them with the smaller eyes and more of the standard LEGO minifigure look. And these are all episode 2 era. You've got Obi-Wan, you've got Padme, and you've got Anakin Skywalker. And these are, all of these have two faces to them. So I'll show you the second face once we get around to the back. I think the most interesting, to me, most interesting looking of these is the Padme figure. It went a little bit more realistic than LEGO even normally does. And you can see that she has the battle damaged episode 2 arena escape outfit on. Obi-Wan actually looks pretty interesting too on this one. I think that, again, a little bit on the more realistic side than normal. Let's take a look at these from the back. And you can see relatively mundane prints on all of them. Again, the most interesting thing here is just got the scratches with the scars across for Padme. Now let's check out the alternate faces. All three of these are kind of the more serious faces, and there's what they look like from the front. Next up, clones and droids. This is a clone trooper captain. You can tell by the red markings. This one's a pilot. You can tell from the torso. And then they give you a couple of the pretty awesome super battle droids. See what they look like. The clones, both of them have the angry clone face. Not that you're going to see their faces very much. Very large, heavy, long-range weapon here, and just a little pistol in the hand of the pilot, because he's not supposed to do much combat directly other than with whatever ship that he happens to be piloting. They also give you a small little speeder, which I will show you later on, actually gets attached to the gunship. It's a cool small little thing. Looks like you can kind of steer it a little bit by just angling this back and forth, though when you put a minifigure in there, it's not actually gonna work out quite perfectly that way. They put a old style backpack on the back to give it a little kind of a satchel there. It's small, but very effective. Looks like what it's supposed to be. I like it. All right. The gunship. This is a big deal. A big deal, literally. Look at the size of the minifigs compared to this thing. That's much more massive than I expected it to be. I haven't had one of the previous versions, and I just didn't realize they were so big. The gunship itself in Star Wars lore has become pretty big too, which is really interesting. It has become iconic. It has become very recognizable as a Star Wars thing. I think it's the first one that has achieved this level of notoriety and recognizability since the original movies. So since I was a kid, and there's something special about that. I think maybe part of the reason that he was able to become so recognizable is the fact that it's also based on a very recognizable and iconic real life gunship, the great MI-24 Hind gunship of the Soviet era, well known from Rambo movie and quite a lot of other stuff throughout the 80s and still flown today. But here it is. Tons of space in this thing, huge cannons on the top, two big rows of flick missiles that you can refill. I'm gonna show you actually that there's an extra store of extra missiles, but so much going on with this thing. I mean, this is kind of like a flying fortress and flying playset also at the same time. Guns that you can rotate here, lots of range of motion on those, and very sturdy. They don't fall apart no matter how much you kind of mess with them. You've got turrets out here that can move out. You can also angle up and all the way down. You can also kind of turn that in, so you can get quite a range of motion with those. You can put people in those. You've got little spots out here on the winglets, the little bubble canopies. More of the same. You can put more people in there. And they're doing, again, what they've done with a number of sets recently, and I like where they're going with this. They've given you spots or pods to place your minifigures that don't use studs. So there's no studs down in there. You just put your minifigure in place and they'll hold in place. So you don't have to worry about pulling them off at the hips when you take them off. It's no sweat to put them in and take them out. I'll show you exactly how easy that is, because this is important to me for playability, being able to just put a guy or a gal into a place, lock them in, and go, rather than having to kind of futz with the specifics of Lego studs. Not a lot of stickers used with this thing. There are some. You can see that's actually a sticker, 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 large sticker there, but not too many. Also detail in the little pods. Use small stickers there, but the right amount, I think, the right amount to capture the detail that you want. Back here at the back, you again have another gun. It's your tail gun with a fair range of motion on that. Not as good of a look to this one. Doesn't have quite as much nice detail with just a few Technic parts used there. But back here, you also get another opening area, and that's a storage area. So all of your weapons and stuff, well, maybe not that one. That one's a little bit on the large side. Kind of can clip it down there, but you know, smaller blasters can fit in there. Lightsaber, is that going to work? Yes, it is. And those things are not going to fall out. So you know, even though this one's kind of sticking out a little bit, that's nice that you can put your figures into this thing, and you know, ones that come with accessories that are going to be put into places where the accessories aren't going to fit, such as these cockpits here or any of the gunner positions. You've got space to put the accessories rather than having to keep them around and worry about losing them. And if you're keeping certain figures with a certain set, it just helps you to get more poses and do more stuff and still be able to keep all the stuff that's supposed to be with the set with the set. Now up front here, here's another thing that opens up. I thought this was pretty cool, kind of a surprise to me. Opens up here straight, so you can see what that looks like from the front. Not too bad. And that gives you another row of flick missiles. So you can use these for recharge yourself, or you can kind of pretend that they are an extra missile battery that maybe when you land, maybe you drop these off and you can use them as a little bit of a ground-to-ground silo. You know, it's just more stuff to shoot, which of course is what we need lots of. And when these close down, they close down very nicely at that nice angle, non-standard angle, to really get the proper look of the gunship, you know, and its geometry. Now of course, one of the big things with the gunship is that it's got all this space in it. You can actually retract these gunner pods all the way in, but even when you do, you see you don't have to move anything to get them to fit in there. You also have these panels at the back, and look at this little Technic little bit of mechanism here. Just turn that right there and it opens up the bay. It's extra wide, so you get 50% more space of that interior room, that interior passenger bay opened up. And very easy to operate this, and it's kind of a cool little feature that they actually allow you to do that. And you can, with one hand, you can open up both sides. So here's one side opening, here's the other side opening. I like that. A little bit more difficult to close. You kind of have to pinch in there to get to this little ball, little toe ball end piece. But once you get it, there you go. Closes in. I think that's really, really nice. Functional. useful for actual play, not just for looks. And then this back here, this rear hatch, this also opens up. And remember I said that the speeder would actually go into this thing? Well, that's where the speeder goes. Goes right there, like so. It just slides itself in. If I can just get it lined up, I'm not looking at it from both sides. There we go. Slides into like a little track, and then it stops. Stops on its own, right at the back, right where it needs to be. And this whole thing folds up, holds it in securely. That is not going to fall out. It's not going to go into kind of a weird sort of, you know, place where it's going to get stuck. Whenever you want to access this, open this up, and it almost slides out on its own. Probably want to load up your figure. Well, you don't have to do that, but you could load up your figure from the inside. You can kind of access this there, or just leave one loaded up, or just open it up this far, load your figure in, and then off it goes. That's pretty cool. I like that. Very convenient, and just fits right in there. Looks good. Good playability, good appearance. This is just a good set. I am intentionally extra critical of sets that are large and expensive, especially ones that are expensive. Things that are large, I expect to work well with multiple kids playing, and at least with lots of minifigures being used, whether you have to add your own or it actually comes with minifigures. This one comes with a good number of minifigures. You can see you can station them in all kinds of places. So that's a good start, but it also has the space to place them and things that you can do with them. Your gunner seat's good. Cockpit, you know, that's kind of normal. You got two seats there, but you don't really do a lot there. You can pretend one is a gunner and operating, you know, a couple of these or something, but it's better to have ones that you can have, you know, actually in something, actually being able to move with something, being able to operate something, and then also being able to carry them. So one thing that's a little unfortunate here, I think, is that the plates at the bottom, at the base of this, don't have full studs going all through them. I think it makes it look nicer, makes it look more clean and kind of, you know, more nicely finished. But it would be nice to actually have a full set of studs down there, so you can just fill this up with as many, you know, especially clone troopers as you can, or whatever Jedi that you want to have out. It would be nice to be able to put figures right over here, so that even when this door is, the side door is closed up, you'd still be able to have more figures kind of visible from the side that are all lined up all the way. That would have been probably a better choice. It's kind of just comes down to looks versus functionality, but you can still fit quite a number of minifigures in there, because you can put them along the edges, and then you can line them up here, and then you can put them down the center also. So not too bad. I'm not going to complain. Also, you can put some inside there in this little front compartment. So there's a lot of stuff that you can do with this. The speeder is a nice extra bonus thing. Space for the weapons, very smart. I'm glad they did that. I hope that they do more. The minifigures look good. They're not too special to me, to my eye, but they're just good. They're exactly what I would hope to see. You can get a couple of bad guys here. Would have been nice to have just a small Trade Federation or Separatist vehicle to shoot at. You know, maybe some sort of, maybe not a flying thing, but just a something on the ground that you could target and take out, or maybe, you know, do an ambush from above, drop Anakin down onto it from above, and he lands in it with his lightsaber or something like that. That would have been cool, but you know what? $120 and almost 1,200 pieces. The price per part is perfect, and to get this many minifigures amongst that, value-wise, this works out really well. Playability-wise, it works out really well. Certainly looks good. And there's one more feature that I didn't show you. Handle. You put a single finger under this, and because it balances a little bit forward of where that is, it's going to keep it hooked. And that allows you to take this thing around the battlefield, fly it around, or just use it as a carrying handle to, you know, take it out or put it back wherever it's being stored. Or if you have some sort of mechanism for displaying and hanging very heavy display items, that's a great place to hang it from. So a win from start to finish. Nothing about this do I really dislike. The thing that I like the least is just the lack of studs in here, but still, you know, absolutely minimal detraction from that. Overall, a very, very well executed, very playable, very fun set, and a good deal, even objectively speaking. So that's it for this review. Thanks so much for watching. Appreciate your support. If you want to see more reviews, well, I've got lots more on my channel, so check out some of the playlists that are already shown on my channel. You can check out some of the previous videos, older things that I've reviewed. And if you want to stay on top of all updates that I do as quickly as I do them, oftentimes before they even show up on YouTube, and also stuff that's never going to show up on YouTube because it's not video related, follow JANGBRiCKS.com. That's my blog, and that's where I post everything Lego related as well as stuff related to other brands of building systems. And on that note, I'm out. I'll talk to you again next time.